Hello friends, and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this tutorial, we are going to cover cycle detection in a directed graph using node coloring technique. So, the problem statement is that we are given a directed graph and we have to check whether it contains a cycle or not. We need to just print true if there are one or more cycle or a false if there are none. Let's break down the problem statement further and understand what do we mean by few keyword used here. In our previous videos on cycle detection, we have covered these keywords. So let's quickly see what they mean. First, it says that the graph is a directed one. So what is a directed graph? Here we see a directed and an undirected graph. The edge of a directed graph is having a direction from one node to another, while the edge of undirected graph is directionless. Next term we used was a cycle. Cycle is basically a closed path where we have a sequence of nodes starting and ending on the same node. Here we have an acyclic and a cyclic graph. In cyclic graph, we have a cycle as if we start from zero, we come back to it after going through node 1 and 2. However, in this acyclic graph, if we start from 0, it goes to 1, then 2, and then there is no path that lead back to the node 0. That is, in this graph, we do not have a cycle. Let's now look at the solution to the problem statement. In this approach, we will use node coloring technique and depth first search. If you are not aware of DFS traversal, you can go through the tutorial that we have covered earlier. So, the basic idea that we will use here is, first, we will color all nodes into three colors, white, gray, and black. White color nodes would be the one which are unvisited or unprocessed. Gray color node would be the one that are being visited or processed. In other words, we can say those nodes whose descendants are being processed. Finally, the black nodes would be the visited nodes, one whose all descendants are processed. This was the coloring technique. Now, if while doing DFS, we get an edge from current vertex to a gray vertex, then we say we have a cycle and this edge as a back edge. A back edge is an edge that is from a node to itself or from a node to its ancestor node. The presence of back edge determines the presence of a cycle. This is the cyclic graph that we are going to use for our algorithm. We will also require these three sets, the unvisited white set, the underprocessed gray set, and the visited black set. Initially, all nodes are unvisited, so they will be in the white set. We start our DFS from node 0. We put this node into our gray set and start processing its descendant nodes. The neighbor of 0 are 1 and 3. Since none of them are in gray set, we choose 1. We put 1 into our gray set. The neighbors of 1 are 2 and 3, both of which are in white set. We choose 2 and put it from white to gray set. Now, since there are no neighbors of node 2, we say it to be explored and put it from gray to black set. This 2 in black set means that it has been visited. Now we go back to node 1. One of its neighbor 2 is in black set and the other neighbor 3 is in white set. We choose 3 and put it into our gray set. Now we see neighbors of 3. 0 and 4 are its neighbor. But we see that 0 is in gray set 2. Since both current node 3 and its neighbor 0 are in gray set, we say that this is the back edge and that we have found a cycle. Here, our algorithm would stop. Let's assume that this edge was not there. So, the only neighbor of 3 would have been 4. We would therefore go ahead and put node 4 into gray set. Now at node 4, we have a self loop. And while covering this edge, we can say that this is again in gray set and that we have found a cycle. Let's look at the implementation of this algorithm. This is the code snippet taken from GeeksforGeeks. We start by initializing the color of all nodes as white. And then for all the nodes that are white, we call our DFS function. If it returns true, we say that we have a cycle, else we say that there are none. Now, this is the DFS function that finds a back edge. It takes a node and the color array. It marks the current node color to gray. It then checks all the neighbor of this current node. If any of it has gray color, then it returns true. If neighbor is not processed and while recursing we have a back edge, then also it returns true. If all descendant of current vertex are explored, we mark it as black and also return false. Let's now look at the complexity of this code. The code will run in big O of V plus E. This is same as we have in depth first search. Here, V are the number of vertices and E are the number of edges. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.